All right, everybody. So what we're going to do today is I'm going to try to make this a quick tour, a full room tour of my animals. Also a little bit of an update. I'm going to try to keep it as short as possible, so I'm going to kind of power through this. And we're going to start on this end and work our way around the room. FYI, that hissing noise you probably hear in the background is the bull snake, who's not very happy to see me today. But we'll get to her later. Alright, so starting off up here, we've got Eli, bearded dragon, about 3 years old. And he's doing pretty good, sitting on his crushed walnut. That's what I was looking for. Below him, and I don't think I've ever, I don't know if I've ever posted a video on this guy or not. And he might not even be able to find him, but, oh, there he is. That's Nibbler. He is a Russian hamster, or a Campbell's dwarf hamster, I believe is the other name for these little guys. And he looks like a tiny black bear. He's adorable. I love this guy. I'm not big on hamsters, but he's so super cute. And he's not friendly. I don't pick him up or hold him. Sometimes I pet him. But he's fun to watch anyway. Sorry I bothered you, Nibbler. He's about a year and a half old. Moving back up and over, we have Steven, the one-armed bearded dragon. And he's taking a real liking to that fake palm there. He likes to curl up right underneath there. It's pretty cute. And he's growing wicked fast. As is Beans. She's growing fast too, and she's actually in shed right now. That's why her head is and legs are hazy looking. There she is, the red bearded dragon. Beautiful lizard. Growing real good. Eating good. Down here, it looks like we've had some shedding recently. These guys are always shedding, it seems. These are, this is Leela and Gorgo, the African fat tail geckos. And this one is Gorgo, and he is the male. Hey, buddy. Yeah. And Leela is, well, we're gonna have to find her. She's gonna be under here, I guess. Try to do this one-handed. And there she is. Yeah, and as you can see, yes, she is missing an eye. I adopted her that way. And she does have to get hand-fed because her aim is just terrible. And it looks like somebody pooped in the wrong corner. Oh, goodness. That's no good. But anyway, over here we have, his name's Ymir. I finally found a name for this guy. I've had him for a few months now. He is a Canthosaur lepidogaster, a brown pricklenape, a species of horned dragon, horned mountain dragon. He's not very friendly. But there he is. He's pretty looking. Sorry to disturb you, buddy, but, you know, your fans, they want to see you. Yeah, you can see he's puffing up his little throat pouch there. Leave me alone. And if you have any specific questions about any of these animals, feel free to let me know in the comments. Here we have the green American tree frogs here, Hyla cinerea. They're doing good. I just cleaned their little viv here, planted some pothos, which is doing good. Let's see if somebody will take a cricket. There we go. And I better get one for the other one. and gone, just like that. That one there is always like a mottled brown and green. It's pretty interesting. This one's usually bright green, and the other one is more mottled colored. But they're both capable of changing color to green or brown. Okay, close that up. Right next door, we have the crested geckos. There is Big Red. And you see where she gets her name. She's a fatty. Hey, girl. And Yoshi is always hard to find. Right there. There's Yoshi. No eggs recently from these two. Maybe in the spring. Although if there's some in there, I wouldn't know it. They'd be buried, no doubt. Lock this one up. Here we have the bullfrogs. African bullfrogs. They're doing good. They're growing. These guys are big suckers. But they're still not full grown. And a fair warning to anybody that gets these guys, they have like huge stinky turds. It's disgusting. Luckily, it's usually in the water dish, which is easy enough to clean out. There we go. Get some crickets in ya. Still hear that snake behind me? Jeez. You'd think she'd give it a rest by now. Okay. Next up, Lunchbox, the cane toad. Gonna have to reach in there, I guess. There he is, or she, hopefully a she. Females get larger. She's doing good. She doesn't want to be bothered. She's just going to hang out in her pot. Well, this one will be a little bit of a challenge. We're going to try to film the snakes, which mostly are probably hiding. But I can see right there is Seamus, the Western hognose snake. I suppose I can dump him out of there so you guys can see him better. There he is. Yeah, look at that cute little face. Love him. Hognoses are great little snakes. Down here we have the gray banded king snake, Namira. You can just see her in that log there. Absolutely beautiful. One of my favorite species of snake. Gorgeous. I'm going to try to stir her up as well. Oh, she sees my finger. She thinks I have food, probably. There she is. Looking beautiful. And we won't bother her too much. Now below her, we have, and I don't have to dig him out because he thinks I have food, Max, the probably female. Ah, jeez, that bull snake. Probably female, but his name's Max, Maxine, I guess. Striped California King. Always looking for food. Great feeding response. Beautiful snake. Love him. Below him, we have to do a bit of digging for her. We have, oh, there she is. That is Paquita, the Everglades. I'm trying to do this with one hand, guys. The Everglades rat snake. Doesn't she look good looking? Yep. Hi, Max. It's amazing the different personalities on all these snakes. I mean, you have like Max here, who's super curious about what's going on. And then behind me, you have that bull snake just all pissed off. Yep, there she is. Yeah, I really want to get her tamed down some. But she is a little intimidating, I'm not going to lie. Once you get her out, though, she usually calms down. I think she's just really cage defensive. And she puts on an impressive show, that's for sure. Just go back in your hide if you don't like me. Anyways, working on getting a bigger cage for her. She'll probably end up in a 40-gallon. Actually, what I really want to get is a snake rack. With some decent-sized tubs, though. I don't want to cramp my snakes up. In here, we have another crested gecko. Here he is, gator face. I think it's a female. But either way. Oh, I got cut off there for a second. Which is fine. It means I can focus better, I guess. Yep. Growing good. Beautiful little cresty. Great colors. Over here, we have Big Mama, the giant day gecko. Looking fat and happy. Look at the size of her tail. Wow. She laid eggs recently, and they got them incubating. Even though she lives all alone, she used to have a mate. Hey there, pretty girl. Oh, don't be scared. Yeah, these guys are beautiful to look at, but not much for a pet that you can hold. And there's Pothos in there too, and that seems to be taking off pretty good. Next up, another one we got to dig out, I guess, although I see him. Ogopogo, the Sheltopusik, Russian legless lizard. Yeah, he's hissing too, but he's not as bad as that bull snake over there. Whoop. Still makes me flinch though. There he is. Sorry to disturb you, buddy. You're gonna get fed soon though, so might as well wake up. He's doing good. Such an interesting animal. Love these guys. Look at the face on him. Come out here and show everybody what you look like. There he is. Looking good, buddy, looking good. If I had to start all over with reptiles, I would do only front opening cages. Okay, there he is. Let's get a good shot of his face. He's so beautiful looking. Yeah, there he is. And his clamp fell off. Okay. Moving around. The fish. Community fish, they're doing good. I got some new additions in here. I got some gold barbs, as you can see right there. So this one's for all my fish followers. There's one. Also got a couple Emperor Tetras. If I can find them. There's one. These guys are really pretty. Look at that. Yeah, this tank's kind of a mixed bag. We got lots of different fish in here. I won't go through them all. The Bloodfin Tetra back there. Glow lights. There's another Emperor. Olivian Ram Cichlids. Rubber Lip Fleco. He's always in that spot. That is his spot. Dwarf Flag Cichlids. Got a couple of those in here. Their tail rasboras, these guys are pushing it, man. They're like 5 years old. I might exaggerate a little bit, but they're either way, they're about three at least. Corydoras, he's got to have a few of those. That's everybody, I guess. There is the Midas cichlid, he's doing good, he's a beast. Look at the size of him. Love that fish. Yeah, come after the camera. Woo! Yeah, he's not that agitated. Raphael, old man Raph, he's doing good too. Same as always with him. Always on the lookout for food. And yeah, he is. I think he'll be 25 years old this year. Well, 25 years that I've had him. He could be older. Might be closer to 30. There's Gamera. The mud turtle. We'll film him until he takes off behind the wall of algae there. These guys are up for a cleaning. The loggerhead. He looks like he's up to something, digging around. I haven't fed him yet, so I don't know what he's looking for. That's a loggerhead musk turtle. I've named him Poncho. He's really up to something. Over here, another new addition. African clawed frog. A big fat one. I think probably a female. So far so good on getting along with the fish. That's my big concern, but they don't bother her. She doesn't bother them. There are the Severums right there. That one in the front there is about 10 years old, so she doesn't look as young and beautiful as the one behind her. Let's see how the catfish are doing. There's the Salfin Pleco, Asian upside down catfish, and the two tinfoil barbs. Also the pim-loaded catfish, who is usually in this PVC pipe. There he is. Okay, moving over here, Cleo the ball python. I guess I have to open this up and show her to you guys. See how she's doing. There she is. She's been off feed for a couple months now. She did eat a couple weeks back, but yeah, it's winter time, so she's not as active as she would normally be, but she's doing good. I've been weighing her regularly. She's not losing much. I won't uncoil her. Let her get her beauty sleep. And I would put these tops back on after filming, but I'm worried I would forget. Turok the Chuckwalla. I just replaced his bedding with his sand with the coconut, ground coconut. Let's see how he's doing. Sorry to bother you too, buddy, but you should come out and eat anyway. He's like an early morning riser. He likes to eat really early in the morning, and if I'm late getting him his food, he's not happy. As you can see, he's not happy anyway. He's not the most social lizard. But he's neat. I like the Chuckwalla. Really cool North American species that you don't see a lot in this hobby, it seems. There he is. Sorry to bother you. I'm bothering everybody today. So there we go. And And sorry for the terrible lighting. I had a blowout on my fixture up here, so working on getting that fixed. But it's dark over in this side of the room. There are the tortoises. Russell is right there. I still don't have a name for her. But they're doing great, man. Look at them go. They just love to eat. And I think I've seen him try to mount her a couple times, which is good because I do want to breed these two. And it's the end of January now, early February, so I really got to get working on that outdoor enclosure. Although realistically, they probably won't go out there until like May, late April maybe. Moving on, here is Reptilicus. He was sold as a high white California King. I know he's a California King, but I'm not sure he's high white. He might be something else. I've seen other morphs that look similar or other localities. Oh, I guess I, for whatever reason, probably should show you the roach colony. There's my roach colony, although they're all hiding. And I'm not going to reach in there and bother them. I'm not afraid of the roaches, whatever. I'll pick them up, but there's a lot to film, and I'm sure the roaches are the least of our concern. Over here, this is Elvira, Eastern Chain King. Let's see if I can get her to come out. This is the problem with doing like snake room tours. It's like, come on, man, work with me, people. She is in there, but there we go. Yep, she's grown some good size on her. Look at her. Beautiful snake. Love Eastern Chain Kings. Love king snakes in general, as you can probably tell from my collection. Yeah, she's doing good. Healthy eater. There's Reptilicus again. He's gotten quite large, although you really can't tell from this video, but he's getting a good size. Maybe he'll come out if he sees my hand. Come on out there, boy. Tortoises again. They like to fight over the same leaves. It's kind of weird. Over here, there's the rabbit. Rupert. He's being adorable, but he will not let you touch him. He is not a friendly rabbit. He'll sit on your lap, but you just, no hands on, unfortunately. But yeah, just want to give him hugs, and I can't. It's frustrating. Come on out. Come see everybody. Okay. Nope, this is not the last snake. There's two more snakes left to show you. This is the Miami phase corn snake, Cornelius. I'm just going to go ahead and take him out because it's so dark. And he's dark, so I want to actually be able to see him. There he is. He's pretty. Look at him. I don't feel like you see a lot of the Miami phase corns around. Probably because the man-made morphs are more popular, but I always like the natural localities. So that's why I picked him up. He's doing good. Typical corn snake. Easy to handle. Eats well. Alright, buddy. There you go. Okay. There we go. Okay, there are Gadnuck and Kevin. Gadnuck is the white one. Kevin is the brown one. Kevin is a female. These are button quail. And these guys are totally awesome. I love these guys. I'm not a big bird person, but, you know, I like wild birds and all that. I love bird watching. But as far as pets go, you know, they're kind of messy. But these two live in an aquarium, so they're okay. And she has a few eggs there. I gotta get those out, put them in the fridge. I don't think she's gonna incubate them. But we've actually pickled a batch of her eggs, and I haven't tried them yet, but I'm looking forward to that. And I have scrambled a few of the eggs and eaten them. I was hoping maybe he'd he'd call. I've had a few comments in some of my other videos on the weird bird calls in the background, and it is him. He has a very prominent call. Over here, the firebelly toads with the pothos, doing excellent. Look at that stuff taking off. Love this setup. There's always condensation on the glass, needless to say, so it's kind of hard to see in there. The newest addition in this tank is this mystery snail, and it has laid 3 egg masses. I've had it for 3 weeks about, and it just keeps pumping out these eggs. And you can actually see these little dots in the glass are some of the babies. Yeah, they're everywhere. But what I'm hoping is that I'll be able to feed them to the loggerhead musk turtle, because they like to eat snails. Oh yeah, there's one of the egg masses, and the other one is on the other side here. I keep hoping to find firebelly tadpoles in here. The males are always singing. But unfortunately, no such luck. I'm going to come around here to the bull snake. Well, not the bull snake, although she sees me again, so as you can see, she's agitated again. But just wanted to quickly stop by and say hello to Rita. She's in shed. I'm not going to bother her. She's a Pueblan milk snake. My very first snake, actually. And a great animal. I love her. She's beautiful, friendly, eats well. Great disposition. Probably what you guys have all been waiting for. For whatever reason, these are my most popular animals, it seems. The southern leopard frogs. There's one there. There's another. These guys have been calling a lot lately. The males are just like crazy every night. And but no eggs. I don't think the females are ready yet. You can see the plants in there are taking off pretty good. I don't know what that leafy looking thing is. The grassy looking one over there is. But that's an umbrella plant, and this is pothos. This pothos stuff is fantastic. I love it. You can just grow it in like any, like it's in dirt in here. And then in here it's in water. And it doesn't care where it's at. It does good anyway. I'm going to throw some crickets in here for you guys, so you can watch them eat. Hopefully, if they're in the mood for it. Maybe not. Just got to be a little patient, maybe. You can see some of the leaves moving. Yep, so yeah, like I said, these guys seem very popular. I get a lot of comments about these frogs. I have to clean their tank because it's kind of a mess. You can see the calcium deposits on the glass, and the dirt is packed down pretty good, so I'm going to fluff that up and add some new stuff. But if you have questions about the leopard frogs or anything you'd like to see in that video, you know, leave them in the comments. Let me know specifically what it is you want to see or learn about them. Yeah, most of them are, they're great at hiding, I tell you that. There goes one. This must be one of the big females right there. And there's 9 in here total, even though it doesn't look like it. There's one back there behind her. And I guess that about does it, everybody. That's everybody. Oh, no. No, it's not. No, it's not. We got to come back around here. I feel bad if I left them out. Parakeets. This is Harvey and Kiki. Harvey gets his name because he's two-faced. You know, he's got, that side looks good. But his other side around his eyeball is missing feathers. Or maybe this is the side missing feathers. Nope. There you go. So you can see his... Sorry about that. It was cut off. Back to Harvey. There he is. You can see his... he had an eye injury when he was in the pet store, and I adopted him. His eye works fine. He's fine. I don't know why he's squinting like that right now. But, that's why he's called Harvey. And his girlfriend over there is Kiki. Although she doesn't put out a lot for him. He's pretty friendly. He's not going to come over while I have the camera, but he'll let you pet him a little bit, and he'll sit on your hand.
Harvey Dent. Can we trust him?
All right, everybody, and that's the room. You've seen it all. Like I said before, if there's anybody you want to look at specifically, let me know. If you have any questions or comments, let me know. And yeah, thanks for watching. Like, comment, subscribe. And I will see you next time.